The next one is advantages of plastic. See, the first advantage of plastic is they are of low cost. So the plastics are relatively low cost, easily manufactured, and are versatile. So due to these properties, they are used in wide ranges of products. That is, they are used in many traditional materials such as wood, stone, horn, and bone leather, paper, metal, glass, and ceramics. The next property is they are non-reactive. As they are non-reactive, they used to store the many reactive substances like the chemicals. The next property is resistant to corrosion. All of you know that metals like iron get rusted when left exposed to moisture and air. But plastic does not get corroded easily when it is exposed to moisture and air. So it is resistant to corrosions. The next one property is low density. They have the low density and high durability. So this property makes them useful for various purposes, like in making the containers to keep entables, in making buckets or the mugs, etc. The next property is poor conductor of heat and electricity. As these are poor conductor of heat and electricity, the electric wires have the plastic coverings. Okay, so this property makes them very useful in making the electric fittings, switches, frying pans, and other kitchen utensils. You have already seen that the screwdrivers, the handles of screwdrivers are made up of plastic. The frying pan handles are also made up of plastic. So plastic is used over there. This is all about the advantages of plastic. Now next one is the disadvantages of plastic. The first disadvantage of plastic is they are insoluble in water. See, they are insoluble in water. That means they are not wholly soluble in the water, and they are relative chemical inertness. That means they cannot combine with any kind of chemicals. So pure plastics generally have low toxicity in their finished state. If you have the pure plastic, it does not toxic in their finished state. So plastics, whenever the plastics are made at that time, variety of toxic additives are added. Why these additives are added? In order to mold them. For molding them, these toxic additives are added. So whenever we use this plastic in food packaging at that time, or the children toys, or in the teethers, tubings, so these traces of these toxic additives or the traces of chemicals can leach out of that plastic, and when it comes in contact with our food, then some compound of leaching form can contaminate our food, okay, and interfere with our body functions, like the contaminate our food and interfere with our body functions means we are suspected to be carcinogenic. The next disadvantage of plastic is they are non-biodegradable, means they cannot easily decompose by any natural process. So this is the most important disadvantage of plastic. Okay, so this is all about the disadvantages of plastic. Now the next one is the impact of plastic on environment. See, when we go to the market, we get usually things wrapped in plastic or packed in polythene bags. So in this way, plastic waste keeps getting accumulated in our homes and ultimately goes in the garbage. Okay, so disposal of plastic, it is the major problem. A material which get decomposed through natural process or by the action of microorganism, that material is called as biodegradable, or that plastic is known as biodegradable plastic. That means it can easily degrade with the help of microorganisms or by naturally. And the material which not easily decomposed by the natural process or by the action of microorganism, that material of plastic is known as non-biodegradable plastics. Okay, so plastics are either non-biodegradable or they degrade very very slow. Okay, so since the plastics are non-biodegradable, they pollute the water bodies. Okay, so plastic takes several years to decompose, so it not environment friendly. It causes environmental pollutions. If we burn the plastic, then it will also release the lots of poisonous fumes into the atmosphere and causes the air pollution. So this problem will solve by avoiding the use of plastic, making the use of bags which are made up of cotton and jute. Most of the thermoplastic can be recycled, so we have to use that thermoplastics. Microorganism cannot decompose plastics easily. So the proper disposal method should be there. See, there should be the separate biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste. If plastic is consumed by the animals, then it will also choke the respiratory system and inner lining of the stomach of that organ of that animals. So it is really hazardous to us. Weather and water can break the plastic down into the smaller particles, even down to individual molecules, which may lead to unpredictable consequences. So since 1950s, 1 billion tons of plastic has been discarded. So all of it is still intact in some form and will persist for hundreds or even thousands of years. So the plastic recycling programs are now common in the world. Thermoplastic can be remelt and reused. Thermoset plastic can be fragmented and used as a filters. So however, recycling plastic is difficult process as compared to the recycling of papers or the metals. So what types of conservative actions we can do against the plastics? Or what are the steps against the pollution which is caused by the plastic? See, pollution caused by the plastic is a serious problem of urban culture. Okay, so how can we take some of the actions against it? So we have to, from the last few years, people are being aware about the impact of plastic on environment. So there are certain actions by which we can conserve the environment. So how it is seen? First one is the limiting use of plastic bags. We have to use only the jute or the cotton bags to carry the things. We have to follow the 3R principle. That means reduce, reuse and recycle. We do not throw the plastic litter on the road. We have to encourage the recycling of plastic and initiate the segregation of the garbage in your local area. Never throw these plastics in the rivers, drains, roads and the sewage system, etc. Okay? See, the biodegradable plastic or bioplastics, they can be made from the plant-based materials. Okay? So these plastics can degrade over a period of time in the natural environment on exposure to sun and air. However, because of their higher cost, they have never replaced traditional non-degradable plastics in the mass market. Okay, so this is all about the plastic, properties of plastic, advantages, disadvantages, and how we can conserve the environment against this plastic, etc. This is the note, students. This note is for you. So you can get the idea about the rayon, nylon, polyester and acrylic by distinguishing them. The next one is the common plastics and their uses. See, here it is, the first plastic is polyvinyl chloride, which is the thermoplastic. So the property of this plastic is much stronger than the polythene. It is good insulator. The uses are, this type of plastic is used in the plumbing pipes, gatherings, shower curtains, window frames, flooring, making shoes, raincoats, bottles, upholstery, electric wires, etc. So in this way, these are the various types of plastics, their property and uses. Thank you.